Hello, and in this video, we are going to learn how to insert automatic numbering for headings and subheadings in Word. So you can see here that I have a very simple list here. It's actually the list of all the headings and subheadings in my next assignment. And what I really want to do is to set up automatic numbering for all the headings and subheadings below it. Okay, so first, we will need to set up the headings. So this is heading 1. Okay, heading 1. Okay, and then heading 2. So these three are heading 2. Also this one, this is 2. And these are also heading 2s. And then finally, we'll set up heading 3. So now we have three levels of heading set up. But heading 2 and heading 3 are very similar and it can create a lot of confusion. Okay, so I'm going to select heading 3. This one is heading 3. I'm going to select the color black. And I'm going to make it bold, and then I'm going to heading 3 and click on this option, update heading 3 to match selection. And you can see here that all the heading 3 have now been updated and changed the color to black and bold. So visually it is easier to distinguish between the different heading levels. So next, let's add automatic numbering for all the headings and subheadings. And for this is actually quite simple. All we need to do is to click on any of the headings. And then go to multi-level list and just select the option that you want. So I'm going to select this option. Okay, and that's done. So now let's go ahead and add a few more headings, subheadings to see if it is working properly. So 2.1 is planning, executing, and then I want to add another subsection for monitoring. Okay, and I'm going to set is as heading number 2. So you can see that monitoring is already been assigned 2.3, which is automatic numbering, and the subheading below it, closing, has already been updated from 2.3 to 2.4. Now let's try to add another one. I'm going to put in project management plan, and I'm going to set it as heading level 1. Okay, and you can see that as soon as I click on heading number 1, then the project management plan will take on the automatic numbering. So it will be assigned heading 2 and all the heading below it will be automatically renumbered to reflect the changes in the document. So with this, and let's say I want to add in a heading number 3. So research design could be methodology. So here I'm going to put in interview method. Okay, and all this will be heading number 3, so 4.2.1 and 4.2.2. Okay, so heading number 3, and there you go. And anytime you delete one of this heading, the whole table will be automatically updated. Let's say that we'll delete monitoring, then everything will be automatically updated. So now we can go ahead and insert a new table of contents. So first, let's insert a page break. Alright, because usually the table of contents will be on a separate page. Okay, now let's go to reference, go to table of contents, and there are a few options here for you to choose from. So I'm going to select this one, and that's done. Now let's try to add some dummy text to see if the table of content is working properly. So I'm going to add just a few dummy tags here and there. Okay, and here research design 4. Okay, and then so I'm just going to add a few dummy tags here and there, very random. Okay, so now let's go back to our table of contents and update the page numbering. It's very easy to do so actually. All you need to do is to click on update field. And here, because our table hasn't changed, we just added a few more tags in it. So all we need to do is to update the page numbers. And that's it. So let's add a few more headings and subheadings to and see how we can update the table of contents. So consideration, and that will be on heading number 2. Okay. And then I'm going to add planning, executing, and before executing I'm going to add in monitoring. Okay, and audit, and it will be heading number 2. All right, so we've added two more subheadings, and let's go back to our table of contents and try to update it. Okay, update the entire table. And you can see that monitoring and audit has been updated. And also consideration has been updated. So that's it. So remember, next time when you're working on a long or formal document, instead of leaving all the headings and subheading numbering and table of contents to the last minute, why don't you try a different approach and then set it up right from the beginning? Not only will it save you a lot of time, but it will also give you a lot of structure to the assignment. And by doing a table of contents right from the beginning, it will give you a much better idea of how to structure your report and give you a holistic approach to your report. So remember, when you're working on a long or formal document, always set up headings and table of contents right from the beginning. And that's it for now. Happy learning, and see you in the next video.